Hello, and thank you so much for tuning in to another Museum at Home. My name is Buddy Stark. I manage the planetarium here at the Museum of Natural History. And what I'd like to talk to you about today is something that's coming up very soon, which is a total lunar eclipse. This happens when the moon falls into the Earth's shadow. And I want to answer a couple of quite common questions, I should say. One of them is, how do I watch this thing, right? Like, what exactly do I need to know to enjoy this upcoming lunar eclipse? And another common question is, why isn't every full moon a lunar eclipse? Because it seems like if the Earth is in between the sun and the moon, we should have that shadow falling on the moon. So we'll address that as well. The first thing I would like to do is swap to a slightly different view here. What I'm using here is a program called Stellarium. And Stellarium is completely free. Basically, it makes your computer, your home computer, a small little planetarium, and it's very useful for learning about the night sky and sort of exploring the solar system. It's very handy, and it's pretty user-friendly as well. That's Stellarium, Stellarium, and I use it for a lot of various purposes. You can see what I've done here is I've come over here to the left, and I've clicked on the date and time window, and I have set the date for May 15th. And the time, if you're not familiar with military time, if you want to use Stellarium, you will have to get used to that a little bit. But I've set the time here for 9 p.m., right? That's 2100 hours. And down here on the bottom, well, actually, what I'm going to do first, I'm going to click on the moon. It's going to give you a lot of information that you don't really have to, for the most part. I mean, you're welcome to dig into that, but for the most part, you don't need it. And then I'm going to come down here to the bottom, and I'm going to click this center on selected object so that we get the moon right in the middle. And I'm going to use my mouse wheel just to scroll in to take a view of the moon here at 9 p.m. You can see at on May 15th this year, we're going to have a full moon. It's always a full moon during a lunar eclipse. Let's see, what else? I want to fast forward time here. That's what I want to do. And so I'm going to come down here and I'm just going to hit this fast forward time button. At 9 p.m., you can see May 15th, it's still fairly bright at 9 p.m. There's still quite a bit of twilight hanging out there. The first thing that we're going to notice as this eclipse starts is around 10:30 or so, or really about 10 o'clock or so, we're going to notice that the moon starts to get very slightly dimmer, and it's really difficult to tell the difference in real time. What's happening there is the moon is falling into Earth's penumbra, or the partial shadow, and all that happens during that portion is the moon gets very slightly dimmer. It's very difficult to actually spot, but if we speed time up, what you're going to see is starting here in the bottom left, moving up across, you're going to see a very, very slightly dimming line go across the surface of the moon. Keep your eye out for that. There it goes. You can see that dimming line going across there. And right about 10:30 is when you're really going to start to notice some changes here on the surface of the moon. That's when the full portion of Earth's shadow, or the umbra, is going to start making its way across as well. So really the time you're going to want to start looking at this, if you want to see the whole thing happen, is about 10:30. Because again, the partial, the penumbral eclipse is very, very slight. It's very difficult to actually spot that happening. But okay, we're going to speed time up again. And here we have Earth's full shadow beginning to march its way across the surface of the moon. And by about 11:30 or so, some people get really particular about the times. I think it's like 11:27. But the point is, if you're outside about 11:30, that's when it's finally going to actually completely, the whole surface of the moon is going to be inside of the Earth's shadow, right around 11:30 or so. So we're going to speed up just a little bit to get there. And at this point, if the Earth didn't have an atmosphere, the moon would basically be invisible. It would be completely black. No sunlight would be hitting it. But because we do have an atmosphere, the sunlight, some of the sunlight actually is able to bend around the Earth because of the air that's blanketing our planet. It acts like a little lens, and it focuses just a little bit of that sunlight back onto the surface of the moon, and the wavelength that bends at about the right angle to get back to the surface of the moon is predominantly a red wavelength, which is why the moon is going to look, instead of going completely black, right, and sort of fading from view, that's why the moon is going to turn this sort of reddish color. Now, a couple of great things about lunar eclipses. One is that they are completely, perfectly safe to watch without any special equipment, right? It's just a slightly dimmer moon than you're used to. There's no danger here. Another great thing about lunar eclipses is that full moons are pretty big to begin with, right? You don't have to have a telescope. You don't have to have binoculars to go outside and enjoy a lunar eclipse because it's pretty easy to spot the full moon. And a final thing that's really great about lunar eclipses, you can see we're already past midnight. This has been going on for about 45 minutes now. A total lunar eclipse actually lasts a pretty good length of time. So even if it's sort of fairly cloudy out, if the clouds ever break, even for a few minutes, within this hour and a half period or so, you can still enjoy the total lunar eclipse. It's going to be ending. You can see it's starting to get a little brighter over here in the bottom right. We're going to start to see Earth's shadow begin to leave the moon at about 1 a.m. And by about 2 a.m. or so, we're going to the eclipse will be completely over, except for the trailing partial eclipse that, again, not visually all that interesting. By about 2 a.m., Earth's umbra will be leaving the surface of the moon, and the eclipse, for most visual purposes, will be over. Now, again, one of the questions that comes up a lot with lunar eclipses is why don't they happen every single month? Because the Earth goes around the sun once a year. I drafted this up very quickly here just as a demonstration. So, of course, the sizes of these are very wrong. It's very inaccurate. And the distances are very inaccurate. So don't take that, don't take this and assume that the distances and the sizes are right. We're just trying to demonstrate why every full moon is not a lunar eclipse, right? So we're taking some liberties about how things actually look in terms of their sizes and distances in the solar system. But we know that the Earth orbits the sun once a year, right? So this is the Earth's orbit as we go around the sun. And again, the size there is way off, but we kind of draw it as though it's conveniently flat for us because we're the ones making this map here. And then when we think about the moon going around the sun, when we think about the moon going around the Earth, we also, a lot of us, I think, we envision that the orbit of the moon looks very similar. And so we'll go ahead and put the moon's orbit that I think a lot of us sort of picture, the moon doing this, right? And this is reasonable, but it's just slightly inaccurate. And that's what causes, I think, a lot of this confusion. Because if the moon's orbit was like this, specifically perfectly lined up with the moon's or the Earth's orbit, right? They're both in the same plane here. Then if this was the case, we would have a lunar eclipse every single month. And somewhere on the Earth, we would have a solar eclipse every single month as well, because again, they line up perfectly here. But this is not actually what the moon's orbit looks like. It's slightly different from this. So let me fix this. This right here is what the moon's orbit actually looks like. Now again, I've exaggerated that tilt, but the important thing is that tilt does exist. The moon's orbit is not perfectly in line with the Earth's orbit. It tilts like that. And so there are times, well, like this coming on May 15th, when the moon happens to be in a position in its orbit that does line up with the Earth's orbit, and it does get a perfect line with the Earth and the moon, and the sun here, and so the Earth's shadow is going to cast on the surface of the moon. And actually, my little demonstration here, I don't have an atmosphere, because again, I made this up pretty quickly, so you can see the moon is completely black in mine because it's inside of Earth's shadow here. If I get rid of that orbit, it's very difficult to see the moon, because my Earth doesn't have an atmosphere, and so the moon is completely in Earth's shadow. But I'm going to get rid of those stars because it makes it a little harder to see things here. But because the moon's orbit is tilted, you can imagine if we go 3 months into the future here, so we just spin things around a little bit. There we go. Something like this. Now this is still a full moon, because again, from the point of view of the Earth, the moon is on the other side of the Earth from the sun, but now it doesn't line up perfectly, right? The Earth's shadow is going to be falling over here. The sunlight is still able to reach the moon in this position because of this sort of tilt. And so once again, if I turn the stars on here, now we can see the moon because it's kind of low. And other times it'll be a little too high. And so it misses that plane most of the time. And this is why not every month, not every full moon, is a lunar eclipse. I hope that makes sense. I hope you are able to get outside this coming Monday or this coming Sunday night, May 15th, and into Monday morning, May 16th, and check it out. And I hope this was useful for you if you were looking to understand a little bit more about why lunar eclipses do happen and why they don't always happen. Once again, thank you so much for tuning in to another Museum at Home. My name is Buddy Stark. And I'll catch you next time. Take care.